Hi guys and welcome back in Medical Scribe. This video is the first video in the Introduction to Anatomy series. And today we will talk about the anatomy definition. The anatomy is a Greek word origin, which means to cut or to dissect something. And the scientific definition of anatomy is that one of the natural sciences that study the body structures and functions, which means that the body composed of what and what's the functions of these structures. Okay, the anatomy in general divided into two types, which is the gross anatomy or the macroscopic anatomy and the microscopic anatomy or the histology. Regarding the gross or the microscopic anatomy, they mean that we will study the different body structures and their functions without using magnifying tools, or we will study this type with our naked eyes only. While the histology or the microscopic anatomy means that we will study the different body structures and their functions at the cells or at the tissues level. So, we will use magnifying tools like microscope. The study of anatomy is an important issue and it considered as the basis of the medical profession with its two main branch, which is the internal and the surgical medicine. That means the medical students won't qualifying as graduated doctors without studying the anatomy of a human body. And not only the medical students should study anatomy. It's supposed that every person deal with the human body should have information making him or her able to do their jobs in the right way and in a scientific manner. The problem that most students face is the difficulty in understanding the anatomy. And I agree with them partially, because we have to understand and memorize a lot of new words and new relations, as many as you can imagine, and a lot of details. And sometimes we don't know the benefit from it. But in fact, when we will correlate this theoretical information with the clinical presentation that we will deal with later, we will know the importance of anatomy. And as always our professor said, in order to diagnose the abnormal, you must know the normal firstly. This means that we must know the normal structures and functions of the human body to be able to diagnose the abnormality if it happened, and then to treat it in the right way. So, what we will learn in anatomy is not just to memorize the names of bones, muscles, nerves, and so on. No, all these details will be the beginning in diagnosing and treating the diseases. Alright, now we will have a very important issue, which is how we will study the anatomy, or what is the approach we have in studying anatomy. In fact, there are three approaches in studying anatomy, which is the regional anatomy, the systemic anatomy, and the clinical anatomy. And every one of these approaches has its own details, and in the upcoming videos we will talk about these approaches and how it looks to the human body. And you know, this is a very critical issue in order to make the most benefit we can and focusing on the things that the approach needs. After that, we will talk about the medical terms related to the anatomy. And finally, we should talk about the body systems in a simple way and from an anatomical point of view. I think you will learn from this series a lot, and you will become oriented when you will study the anatomy of the human body. And that's it. I hope what I said makes sense. See you later and goodbye.